And welcome back to the Roadshow. This morning in the buzz, you may, of course, not want to look at the price of gas on your way into work this morning.
Too
the
late
latest,
now.
The latest nationwide survey shows the average price jumped 16 cents over the last week, making the national average an even $3.50. Who can afford that? That is the highest in 2.5 years. And now the Obama administration is considering all options to combat the rising prices, including tapping into the nation's emergency oil reserve. Take a look.
All matters have to be on the table when you go through, when you see the difficulty coming out of this economic crisis we're in and the fragility of it.
The government has tapped into the reserve before, back in 2005, and after they did that, oil prices sank 9%. I say go for it. What do you think?
Seems like an emergency to me.
Goodness.
It's a no-brainer. The thing that bothers me, the fact that we have to rely, I mean, have you seen what's going on over
it's
in the
ridiculous.
Middle East? These people, I mean, it's out of control. And the fact that we in this country, this superpower country that we live in, have to rely on other countries to put fuel in our cars, put oil in our oil tank.
99% of what we have, everything is made overseas. Right.
It is absolutely mind-boggling. Yeah, you need to tap into it, and you should have tapped into it when gas prices hit $2.50 a gallon.
And it can be the slightest thing that just jacks up gas prices. I mean, anything.
It's changed. It's changed the way my family does things as far as planning trips or doing
you
things.
You don't anymore.
Yeah.
What can we do around the house? You know, what's cheaper? Yeah. You don't even want to leave when you don't have to.
Oil prices, too, we were talking about earlier. I just got another $450 bill. A couple weeks earlier, $500 bill. I mean, it's every... Oh, can't take it.
I mean, when I sit... We don't call the oil company anymore. Like, you hope that the oil tank in the basement will just magically fill itself.
Yeah.
But, when the truck rolls down the street...
You're going to run out and be like, don't do it!
Like, please don't come to my house, please don't come to my house. But you need it to come to your house eventually, and you're right. I mean, it's... I understand what it's not the oil company's fault.
No,
I mean, it's not,
it's
the heating company that you call to fill your oil tank.
Right.
But, it's affected how we do things in our family.
Nuclear power plants, are you for them?
I don't care. Listen, in a controlled environment, if it's a safe thing, I'm up for anything to make it better. I'm not going to go skiing in New Hampshire. I'm not going to travel. What are plane tickets now? I'm not going to travel to Florida to do these things with my family. I've got 5 people now in my family, even a family of 2, you know?
It's tough. And I mentioned the other day of how, I'm just filling up my gas tank and I feel like I'm driving an SUV.
Right.
And I'm not. I'm driving a small car, but because I'm filling up and I'm spending $45 and I'm stopping at 45. That doesn't even fill my tank at that point. I get to it and I'm like, I'm getting sick over this. I need to stop. $45 is plenty.
Yeah.
More than
Danielle Morath was saying. I think I heard, was watching last week. She said she was like filling up 10 bucks at a time.
I said the same thing.
Yeah. Of course, every so often.
Yeah.
That was like a one-time deal. And I was like,
And then you say, I'm going to find a gas station that's got cheaper per gallon. So you go from
driving all
$3.48 down to $3.39 a gallon. And you're right. And the amount of time you spent driving around
with
the other gas stations. The thing that bothers me about the whole thing is that, like I said at the beginning, we have the resources at our, Alaska and offshore, the Gulf. Mm-hmm. We have the places we can do this. For some reason, we don't. I don't know if it's because we don't want to tick off
potential
trading partners in the Middle East.
We want to be
friends with everybody. But yet these countries that are out of control, we're the first ones to roll up with our battleships and bomb the heck out of them in order to get them under control. Can we just build like a big fortress around our country and just... We'll just worry about ourselves.
Well, they're saying it's an emergency supply, and like this screams
emergency
to me. I don't know about that,
so
there should be no hesitation.
Courtney, I get so angry driving by the gas station, and again, it's not the gas station's fault, but then I take that anger home with me, and then my wife says, why are you all stressed out? I say, because we spend $150 a week on gas, we got to eat, blah, blah, blah.
Do you have an SUV?
Yeah.
Would you get rid of the SUV because of gas prices, or are you one of those that... has to have the SUV?
Well, with 3 kids, I need a little more room.
Yeah, you need a little bit
it's
more
the small
room.
School bus that I
think you're going to need a bus soon, right? I don't think you can backtrack from an SUV there. And, we're talking about things like that where we kind of feel trapped into having to get gas because you have to get to work, get around, run errands and things like that. So everyone's sharing what they're doing to maybe cut corners with the gas price situation. So we'll head to the live blog first. And Smokey Wolf says, it has affected me in a way. She says it's making it very hard to go out and look for work when you have to get gas every day while looking looking for a job. So she says she's actually looking less out on the road and even more online because the prices of gas. Here's our poll right underneath the live blog. Has the spike in gas prices affected your daily routine? A, yes, I've changed my driving habits. B, no, I'm not driving less than usual. Or C, I don't really think about gas prices. And I've also posted the latest story about the gas price jumping 33 cents in the past 2 weeks. So you can read up some more on that. Here's a snapshot of our Facebook page. We have about 10 or 11 comments so far. And Donna Stanley says it has not affected her. She still has to go to work. Crystal Allard says no, it's not, but making her budgeting a little off. And Adam Thoreau says, luckily for him, he says, I live, work, and visit my girlfriend all within a 4-mile radius. But he says he will keep it in mind the next time he tips the delivery driver. So if you guys have some more gas tips, we'd love to hear them. It comes at a great time this week. So post them on our Facebook page or visit us on the live blog if you're on foxprovidence.com. But for